back in December, Warren Hellman passed away. He was an investment banker in San Francisco, and he formed a company called Hellman and Friedman, and they were a huge investment banking firm with billions of dollars. But there was a quote that was attributed to him in the San Francisco Chronicle in 2005, and it got my attention. At least a phrase got my attention. "The companies we buy, for the most part, are large, profitable enterprises, though they may have a curable blemish." Curable blemish. That got my attention. I began to think about small businesses in particular because that's where my heart is. Do you have a curable blemish? Does your business have a curable blemish? Is there something that maybe you're ignoring, hoping it will go away? But there's a cure. You're just not fooling with it. You're just not messing with it. You're just not trying to find a cure. Lots of people ignore things, hoping they'll go away. Sadly, things far more serious than blemishes. You hear stories every day. We hear stories about the people that we know who've gone to the doctor and they've been diagnosed, and it could be something pretty serious, maybe even something fatal. And they will say, "Yeah, you know, well, I've been feeling this or I've been feeling that for a good while." And even, I mean, come on, today, don't we think, what are you thinking? You know, some of us are so paranoid, we don't want to ignore any little sign. You know, you watch Dr. Oz and you read Men's Health or Women's Health, and there are all these checklists and there are all these signs and there are all these, this symptom, it could be this, something serious, and it could be nothing, but it could be something serious. You know, better to have it checked out. And with our businesses, there are similar things, and sometimes we just ignore those things. Sometimes we think, well, no big deal. I'm thinking in particular of some HR things that I've been involved in through the years. And boy, they just don't seem to get better over time. I'm thinking of a number of different scenarios where people had some situation and, okay, just, I should probably handle that. I should probably do something about that. And they don't, they ignore it. And okay, then later, okay, now something else happened. Well, you know, and invariably they lament the fact that, man alive, I had an opportunity to handle this 6 months ago and I didn't. And now, you know, now it's not a blemish. It's a boil now. It's a really big, painful, messy thing. Yeah, it happens. It happens. It can happen because we're distracted. It can happen because we procrastinate. It can be happening because we just ignore it. We look the other way. It can happen because we assume it's nothing. But it could be. It could be something. But curable. Let's end on a high note, shall we? Curable, a curable blemish. Something you could do something about. You know, we could dissect this thing and turn it 8 ways to Sunday. You know, a blemish isn't necessarily something catastrophic, but it could develop into something that, well, it could develop into something that leaves a scar. That's possible. Or we could just handle it. We could deal with it. Painful though it may be, irksome though it may be, distracting though it may be, and fix it. Fix it. And that's really kind of the phrase. Fix it. Fix what ails you. Examine it, acknowledge it, and then deal with it. And my advice to myself mainly and to you is, let's deal with it in a way that fixes it once and for all. Now, does that mean that we'll never have a blemish again? I was around some young people, and some of them were lamenting, you know, various bobos that had erupted on their face. And I'm like, I'm not a kid, but I had an ingrown whisker like on this jawbone over here. And I'm like, you know, so it can happen to the best of us. And unlike some of these good looking kids, I can't afford a blemish. I mean, I need another blemish, you know, come on. I've already got the proverbial face for radio. Happens, you know, it happens. Well, you know, I fixed mine. I got some tweezers and I pulled out the ingrown whisker. And within a matter of days, problem solved. Now, have I permanently fixed getting ingrown whiskers? No. I'll get another one eventually. But that one came up and I handled it and I dealt with it. That particular episode is fixed. And we need to do that with our businesses. We have these circumstances, these situations, they come up, they erupt, they may come up overnight. They may be something that progressively has gotten worse, but jump on it. Jump on it as quickly as you can, deal with it, fix it, and then get on about your business. Because they can get worse. And unlike a teenager who has a blemish, well, the likelihood is, yes, over time, it will likely go away. But it's possible that things get a lot worse before they get better. Yes, my ingrown whisker probably would have become infected. Nature probably would have forced it to come to a head, and for that ingrown whisker to have, you know, just almost forced itself out. But yeah, it would have been a much bigger situation on my face than it needed to be, because the solution was pretty quick and painless. And many times that's how it is with our blemishes. Many times in our businesses, we have these little circumstances and situations that come up, and they can be handled reasonably, effectively, quickly, and painlessly before they erupt into something that requires major surgery or major medication if we would just get busy about it. So, the companies we buy, said Warren Hellman, for the most part are large profitable enterprises, though they may have a curable blemish. Take a hard look at the blemishes that you have that are curable and get busy curing them. My name is Randy Cantrell. The website is bulanetwork.com, and this is the Yellow Studio.